Стой.
You are Saxon scouts.
We are not. We're out hunting when your men attacked us.
You have been sent by Curdic to spy on our land.
We're friends. Come closer, you know me.
Have them killed at once. Bury them on the far side of the hill.
What is happening? Tell me!
We have captured two Saxon scouts, sire.
I am Arthur.
Take me to him.
Where was your father slain?
At the Battle of Ilchester.
And he gave you this clasp?
It came from you. It was your gift.
Not for you.
No. My mother gave it to me.
Cut them loose at once.
When last we met, I was not afflicted. I could see you then as a stripling of 16 years.
You are strong. You're a man.
My companion is Kai, the adopted son of Lud.
Lud? It is enough that you're the son of Lud to be welcome at my hearth.
Morkant, can my hands and ears see more than your eyes, Morkant?
It would appear so, sire. I pray forgiveness for so grave an error.
Then we must forgive the error, must we not, Kai?
This lad is my only remaining relative. He is my grandson, Tarn. Now I must show some hospitality. You shall be my honored guests. Come.
Magic is your spell. Your breath,
I drown. Who is it that sings so beautifully?
Goda, daughter of Howell.
Such a beautiful voice that sung such a sad song.
I remember such sweet words before. Sweet, gentle words that still ring in my ears. sweet, gentle words that spoke of love.
You pig! Let me pass.
Not until you hear me out. I did come back.
With such haste, you must have used up 10 horses in your eagerness to return. I waited for days and days. I knew I was moving on.
But not where you were going.
You left me behind. How could I know you'd ever come back?
But I did.
You should have taken me with you in the first place.
To war? When you've carried my spears for me into battle? You should be pleased that I found you again. Not scowling at me as if I was some marauding bear.
I'm cursing my fate. Whatever the war's between us, it can never be again.
You've taken a husband? And you are free. You're betrothed.
To Morkrend.
Morkrend? That weasel. I think there is something you should learn. How to welcome a man who has sought you for 3 out of the 4 seasons.
No, Kaya cannot.
Where is Kai? I do not hear his voice. I trust he is not sick.
He has a sickness. One that reoccurs every time he sees a pretty face.
Huh?
More wine,
witch. You will need a fresh horse, well fed and watered for the long journey ahead.
Journey? I'm not going on a journey.
As of this moment, as that cloud passes before the sun. So you are betrothed to me.
No word to my father, no formalities.
No, none. As a hawk drops from the sky, from this moment you are mine.
Your prey.
I am my woman.
No, Kai. I cannot go with you.
I shall be waiting for you at daybreak.
Kai! It's too late now.
Coming?
Yes.
Well, come then. Stop behaving like a lovesick goat.
What would you know of such things?
God's teeth, you deserted the girl last time you met her. Now you spend an hour with her and expect her to come running when you whistle. You...
I knew she'd come.
Have you taken leave of your senses?
Yes, I have. Heaven help us.
And from the far north, too, comes the sound of axes as these Saxons fell our trees, steal our land.
I know this. It was ever so. But would you have me deaf? As well as blind.
Do you think that Arthur alone can keep these walls from our door? He cannot work miracles.
Here, give me a hand, boy. Give me a hand. That you seek my place, Morkrend, this is clear. That you shall be regent when I am dead until Tarn comes of age. This I have sworn, but at this time, Arthur
needs our help. Alone, he is not strong enough. Together, we can be more powerful.
You're right. I sanction your plan. Leave Howell in command of our camp. Take 15 men. Swear your allegiance to Arthur until such times as you feel our land is not directly threatened by the Saxons, huh?
15 men.
It will be enough.
Against Arthur, we will need 100.
If we had to surround his village, yes. But with the advantage of surprise, 15 men will suffice.
But he has this system of warnings, of defense. He's renowned for it. How are we going to surprise him?
Supposing there was someone who would tell us the secret of that defense, we could attack a sleeping village.
You know of someone who would turn traitor?
I know of one.
My friends, see before you the happiest man in the world. And today is the finest day that ever was.
It looks like rain.
Let it rain, it's still the finest day. Because I have come home with Goda, daughter of Hywel of the tribe of King Athel, who is to be my bride. We'll have none less than Felix, abbot of Gloucester, to marry us. The wedding will take place on the morrow.
It'll take a day and a half to ride to Gleevum and a day and a half back.
Then the wedding will take place in 3 days. Silvira.
Will you do me the honor of taking Goda into your house until the wedding?
And in 3 days' time, you'll be invited, nay, commanded, to attend the wedding feast. It'll be a day of celebration and rejoicing.
Some smoke over there.
You touched a signal.
Signal?
Just loud enough to warn of danger.
But soft enough for the sound not to carry to your enemies.
Not through the natural rustlings of the forest. The system covers every approach to the village.
And just by treading on those ropes, you're warned.
And we send up smoke, which is seen in the village. And if it should be night, there's the horn.
How clever it all is.
Goda.
I've discovered their system. You must relay my message very carefully to Morgan now. And tell him also that I keep my faith. There's a defense system of ropes surrounding the village. Now, if anyone treads on them, they set off the alarm.
Goda!
Through the forest.
I must help Silvira prepare the supper.
You work too hard. You deserve
something. I deserve you.
The abbot could be delayed. Might be sick and not come at all. And she did say she deserved me. It would be discourteous to keep a lady waiting. So she shall have what she deserves. Goda. Goda.
We attack from there.
She's gone.
Goda, perhaps she went down to the lake to bathe.
Taking all her belongings with her. She's left the village. Gone!
She can't have gone. Where was the smoke? Where was the warning?
Does she know about the signals?
Not from me.
She must have known. Now, who else knows?
Go back to your horse. Ride to the village and tell King Athol that Arthur has betrayed us, led us into a trap. But we fought gallantly, and victory will be ours this day.
But Morgan...
Go!
Woman or child is to remain alive.
Attack, I say!
There's too many of them.
Thank you.
Tarn has explained that...
Tarn! Where is Tarn?
He's safe, unharmed. And he has explained that Morcan cheated you. Hold your sword! We are not enemies.
Enemies we are! And enemies we shall be!
Enemies?
I have been brought word that Kai, your Saxon friend, has killed Morcan.
Morcan cheated you and would have killed me.
And you, who sat at my table, ate my food and drank my wine and clasped my hand in friendship, you came to my village with sword in hand seeking vengeance. You came as an enemy. Now you leave as an enemy.
What of Athel? Athel knew nothing of the attack. And what of your traitor?
She got what she deserved.